it's morning time. We're gonna go check on Shelby. We got more videos to do. Let's see what she's doing. Shelby, what are you doing? It's like 5:30 in the morning.
I have to edit.
Edit what?
Videos.
Videos? Well, we have more to make. You've been up all night editing videos?
Yes.
Well, you better get some rest because we got some vegetable soup to make today.
Okay.
And you got... I don't want to turn the light on, but you got Prince in here with you too, editing videos?
Yes. He's helping me.
All right, so I'm going to let Shelby get a little bit more rest, and she's been up all night editing these videos for you guys to watch. And once she gets up, I'm going to meet you down in the kitchen. We are going to make a vegetable soup that is out of this world. I would say I'll see you in the a.m., but it is the a.m. But like I said, I'm going to let her take a nap, and I'll meet you downstairs. Oh, yeah, one more thing. Prince has been up all night with her, too, so look at him. He needs a little rest. We're going to let him rest as well. Okay, so I'm checking to see if Shelby is finally awake and ready to start this wonderful soup we're going to make today. Are you ready?
Yes.
Did you get some rest?
Yes.
Good deal. Let's see if Prince got rest too. Prince, are you ready? Are you ready? Oh, he looks like he still might need some rest. We're not going to wait on him. We are going to make this fabulous soup. Meet you downstairs.
Before I go downstairs, I just really want you guys to subscribe to this channel. We are so close to our goal, and I just want you to subscribe. Please tell family and friends so they can subscribe too. If you like cooking or baking, please subscribe and like this video.
Hey guys, so now we're downstairs. Everyone's ready to go. Everyone's alert. Even Prince decided to join us. Look at him, well rested. Shelby's well rested. So now what I'm going to make for you today, I'm going to make a vegetable soup. It's just a basic vegetable soup. I try to, on Sundays, make a meal that's going to last for Sunday and for the next day because Mondays are hectic. Everyone's going back to work. Trust me, I want the leftovers. I want to come home, relax, eat leftovers, not cook the next day. So if you want to add some meat, if you don't want just pure vegetables, go ahead, add some even hamburger, make like a hamburger stew. That's one option. But I'm just gonna use vegetables. I've been pigging out all weekend. I wanna do a little cleansing, eat a little healthy, or feel like I'm eating healthy. So for my soup, I have a vegetable stock. I'm gonna pour those in. All right, now usually I like to put a whole onion, yellow onion, in for flavoring. Unfortunately, I don't have an onion in my refrigerator, so I'm just gonna dash in some onion powder. Gives it the flavor. I'm also gonna add to my little broth some bay leaves. I love bay leaves, I love the flavor. You just add them in. I'm gonna add two in there. So the vegetables I'm gonna put in my soup today, I'm gonna put some whole carrots. Now I have organic carrots. I have celery. I'm gonna put some fresh green beans. I always love to use fresh green beans. And I also love tomatoes in my vegetable soup. Now I have canned tomatoes today. I got them in the sauce because I had somebody make me a vegetable soup and they put a little V8 juice, or you can use tomato juice. It gave it the best flavor. So I always use the tomatoes in the sauce for that flavoring. Now you can throw in mushrooms, you can throw in cabbage, you can throw in whatever veggies you like. So first I'm gonna start with my carrots because they take a little bit longer to cook. So I'm gonna cut my carrots up first and I'm gonna cut them into rounds. So I already have them peeled. Now I have my stock right now at like a medium heat while I'm dropping all my vegetables in just to get everything going. And then once I get everything in there, I'm gonna turn it down to low. So let me finish cutting up these carrots and then I'll tell you what we're gonna add next. All right, so next I'm gonna add in my celery. Now, just like with the carrots, I added 3 carrots. The organic carrots that I got were fairly big, so that's why I only used 3. If you wanna make a huge stock pot of soup, use more. Everything is gonna be to your family's numbers, however many people you're cooking for. On the celery, I do have the whole package of celery that I've got, and I've already cleaned it, because you're gonna wanna clean all your veggies. And I'm gonna cut the tips off of each side. And then I'm just gonna chop away. When you have the bigger cutting board, you just drop them in, and look at that. All right, so next I'm gonna add my green beans. I love green beans in a vegetable soup. I did get the fresh green beans. Now, if they don't have any at your grocery store, I know they're out of a lot of different produce things, feel free to get canned or frozen. That works too. Now, if you have the fresh ones, like I got after you wash them, of course, you're gonna wanna cut their little tips off on each side. Just give a good chop. Now, depending on if you like them shorter, you can cut them in half. Or if you like the whole bean, toss it on it. So now we like our green beans a little bit smaller, so I'm gonna cut all mine in half before plopping them in. So the last of my veggies I'm gonna add today is my tomatoes. Remember, keep it in that sauce and you just add them in. Now if you have some leftover ripe tomatoes at home that you need something to do with, you can always add those to your soup too instead of canned. Only thing, make sure you boil them, peel the skin, then add them in. Another thing you can add, which I'm not going to add today, is mushrooms. Mushrooms are great if you get like the portobello already sliced mushrooms, or the whole ones, you can slice them yourself. It'll give your soup a nice beefy flavor. I am going to add a few more seasonings to this. I always like to add some Italian seasoning. That's pretty much good in anything you eat. Now, if you're wondering what to do with those little celery stalks that have the leaves on them, I'm going to show you what to do. Don't throw them away after you clean your celery. Chop them up. It gives great flavor to that soup. So if you don't have celery salt or celery weed, use this, because you already got the celery in your soup. Great flavor, pretty color. Now, there is one last little ingredient I love to add to my vegetable soup, because I have the tomatoes in there in the sauce. I've got Italian seasoning. I sprinkle some Parmesan cheese on top while it's cooking. I don't even stir it from here on out. I just pop the top. I'm gonna turn my heat down to low, and I'm just gonna let it sit for a couple hours. So I'll meet you back here, and then we're gonna stir our soup. That Parmesan cheese flavor is gonna be mixed together. We're gonna check our veggies to see if they're soft. And then it's dinner time. All right, guys, so I've had my soup cooking for about 3 hours. And now that all really depends on how you like your veggies. I don't like mine too mushy. I like them not too mushy, not too crisp. Just right, just like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Just right. So sometimes I will taste one carrot. Once those carrots are a perfect consistency, the rest of your soup is done. Now, I hope you remember we put those bay leaves in there. You don't have to take them out. You can just leave them in there because they'll continue to flavor your soup as you store it in the refrigerator. Because remember, we're making leftovers for tomorrow. Tomorrow's hectic. Monday morning, we don't want to come home and cook. We're going back to work. Kids are going back to homeschool, I guess. So we're going to have a dinner already waiting for us. Now here I have my soup bowl and I have some crackers all around the side. Now I'm going to use, depending on if you like more broth, I like more broth. Spoon in the broth here. So I'm spooning in some broth. Then to get those good veggies in there, I have a spoon with a hole. So you get all those nice fresh veggies. Put them right there in that bowl. Okay, so now I've got my delicious soup in here. And hopefully you remembered, we did add some of that grated Parmesan cheese while it was cooking to give it that flavor. But I also have some freshly grated Parmesan. I'm gonna put that right on top. It goes so well with the soup, any soup actually. And hey, what doesn't Parmesan cheese taste good on? I haven't come up with one thing yet that I didn't like it on. So now I got my crackers on the side for dunking. You can let them swim around there. If you like them soft, leave them set for a minute. Now I'm gonna let Shelby try this because this is her dinner. Well, mine too, but I want her to try it because she's not a big veggie fan, but she loves them cooked in a soup. So I'm gonna let it cool off for just a minute. Don't want her to burn her tongue. And she's gonna try it for you. And she's gonna get a bite of each one of those veggies in one spoonful. All right, Shelby, try that soup. Let me know what you think of those veggies in there.
Mm. 10 out of 10. I'm definitely going to try this again.
All right, guys, so there you have it, a vegetable soup that even kids should like. Now, remember, we added that tomato with the sauce, so it gives that broth some extra flavor. That's what makes it a little more tastier than just your run-of-the-mill broth. If you want to add some meat to this and still make it quick and simple, you can mix up some hamburger, just get some ground beef, ground chuck, fry it up on the stove. Stick it right into your soup stock pot. After it's cooked, that meat will give it flavor. If you want to add different veggies, I like corn, I like mushrooms in there. Whatever you have on hand, it's all gonna work in this. Remember, we're looking for quick and easy meals, still on lockdown, we're still trying to get out of the house. Don't know about you, but we just got ours extended for another month. So hopefully you'll still join me back here for all these easy meals. Thank you for watching me make one of my favorite soups, a vegetable soup. It's getting springtime. This is probably gonna be the last time that I'm gonna make a hot soup. So I had to savor it now before it gets too hot outside, where we'll be grilling and chilling for you soon. Once again, thank you for watching Cooking with Jen. I'm Jen. Be kind and subscribe.